How many bands are there in there? Four?
Well, there's, I think there's three outside and three or four outside and three east-west. Just, there's only three inside. East-West Disciple and Stryper.
Stryper rocks. I mean, I'm totally into the old school. I mean, this is gonna become a new school. I'm bringing it back. Stryper is bringing themselves back. God's bringing it back.
First time?
First time. Magic
that was
Mountain.
Magic Mountain.
Yeah, Magic Mountain back in 84.
85, right before Soldiers Under Command came out, so I'm a Magic Mountain.
I used to just plug it in. It doesn't matter, man. You know, I'd jam it full throttle, bro. Pioneer, whole nine yards, dude. When I got the kick-ass tape, you know, sorry, not kick-ass, but you know what I mean.
Stryper's is going to be so awesome, man. This makes up for 10 years ago I wanted to see Stryper in mass, and they canceled.
They're still as good-looking as they were back then. I'll say that. Definitely.
How can you look at that face and ask that question?
Yeah, first time. I can bring my kids to a Stryper show. I'm not worried, you know, because I know the Lord reigns in everybody's lives here, you know. I still keep an eye on them, but, you know, I think it's a good experience for them.
I think it's going to be great just to see him after all these years, but I would hope that it would be a new beginning.
Yeah, hopefully. You know, see him on a world tour type of thing, see a live album come out.
They're God's servants. They're God's anointed servants, and they spread God's word around, and they tell it like it is, and I have missed them real, really, really bad.
You know, Christianity and rock and roll have kind of had these odds against one another, which I have no idea why. You know, rock and roll is not the devil's music. I didn't get in this to rebel. I was rebelling against rebellion.
We were this new thing, you know, in Christian, I mean, it had never really been done before, Christian metal, you know.
You guys think you created the whole genre?
I don't think we created it. I think God through us opened a whole new door. Talking to all the people here, I've had time and time again, people, person after person come up and say, you know, you saved my husband, and if it hadn't been for your being for Stryper, we wouldn't have met. And my daughter was a drug addict, and, you know, through your music, she, you know, just all sorts of stories.
It touches lives, no matter whether we're together or not. The music is still touching people's hearts, and that's what makes me believe it's more the music than anything else.
Yeah, I think a lot of lives have been changed. I didn't, nothing that I personally did, as you know, but, you know, being a part of a group, you know, I was up there playing music, you know, and everything else that was going on was pretty much people's lives that were changed were done by the Holy Spirit. It had nothing to do with me whatsoever, but.
I guess you can never take another shower.
Probably not. I have to go over to the tattoo booth afterwards.
None of this stuff is being manufactured. This is all memorabilia that I collected either as mom or manager, right, or both.
This is one of the first ones made. It's got the stripe down the arm. Very rare. Right. This bumper sticker right here was the very first Stryper bumper sticker, and it was only made in a quantity of 500. And it was made in 1984, early 84.
Wow.
So today, was $50. That's $25. That's a deal.
I don't think they invented Christian metal, but I think they invented melodic Christian metal. I don't think anybody else had the variety in their sound. I don't think anybody else had the unique look that Stryper had. And a lot of bands didn't have the heaviness that Stryper had. When they broke up, they had sold over 7 million.
They were the first ones to really come out and just rock for God and do it in the secular market, you know, and yet not hide Christ in the process. They continued to dress like they dressed. They continued to be themselves.
Hey! Are you ready? When you out on the streets and you looking for love, I'm calling your name from above. Ripping your life in the ways you don't like, the devil is ready to strike. It's your time to shoot.
If there's anybody in this world that has a right to be mad at God or mad at the world, it's me. Stryper to me was a dream come true. I had worked my whole life for it, and it was absolute bliss. And then it came crashing down hard. All of it, we get a phone call, your tour's canceled, there's no tour support, your record company's out of business. What are you talking about? And the people who were supposed to be paid by a record company weren't paid. Well, a little while later, you know, the marshals knock on the front door, and I'm served with this piece of paper for $975,000 in debt. Wow. And I, you know, I'm like ready to hit the floor, you know, and my head's spinning. I don't even really know what's going on. So I'll end it with this, just to kind of let people know what it was that I went through. I get on my knees and I ask God for $1 million, just to cover this bankruptcy thing. And I tell them, Lord, you got to do this for me. And $1 million check arrives in the mail about 5 days later. And all it says is, enjoy your gift. So I take it back, go down to the bank. I knew the manager of the bank. And I give it to her. And she said, it looks like it's good. It looks like it's drawn off some platinum account. And, you know, the person's rich. But we got to wait 10 days. So how do you think I feel for those 10 days? Okay, I'm like on edge. Thank you, God, this is awesome. 10 days later, the check's no good. And this was, yeah. And then, you know, from the skyscraper to the street, man.
You know, it was inevitable. We gave it 10 years, you know, which is longer than most groups.
Music was changing radically. And, you know, we would have to completely change our style of music, which wasn't the thing to do, in my opinion. You just don't do that.
The Seattle scene was going down now, so you know, Nirvana and all those kinds of groups coming in, and all the hair bands from the 80s were, you know, their history. You know, Mike informed us that he would be leaving the group, and I kind of knew, you know, he wasn't really happy doing what he was doing.
It was a very difficult situation, but I did what I had to do, you know, and made the call and through a lot of prayer and did it, and it was really difficult.
I'll tell you honestly, I mean, there were some things that happened during the Against the Law period that I feel in my heart that God's hand was in the whole thing. It was stopping what we were doing, you know, and I think to teach us some lessons. You know, I can't speak for the other guys, but, you know, I was drinking a lot. I was cussing and, you know, being lewd and, you know, that kind of stuff. I had a problem with, I never slept with anybody, okay, but I did have a problem with flirting with girls.
Hey, I'm going to bring a band up here. Actually, it's a group here. A group that's going to come out, and they're going to do some stuff for you. They're going to perform for you right here. second annual Stryper Expo.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
I want you guys to give us a round of applause here for priesthood.
This is Dakota. She is 7. This is Blaine. He's 4.
Hey, Blaine.
This is the third one in the tummy here. This is my wife, Victoria.
Hey, Victoria.
Hi.
So is this a future band we're looking at here?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe. Yeah. Maybe. Maybe the future Britney Spears or something. We'll see. You know, I feel in life you have a purpose. And I know that Stryper was Michael, Oz, Tim, and Robert's purpose. I know that because I saw what it did. If the band was back together, it would just be, it would be massive. And I don't want to do it because it'd be massive. I want to do it because it'd be the right thing to do.
I don't want to do a reunion because it's about, this guy calls and says, I got 25 grand, will you do this show? You know, I don't want it to be about the money or about, you know, all the numbers. I want it to be because we know it's right and we know it's the time and, you know, it's got to click.
Yeah.
So. That's what I've always said, you know, pretty much. But some people, not all people, but some people don't understand that. It's like, why? Just do it, you know?
Well, I mean, I think all of us would be, you know, excited to see something happen. But it's just really, it's, if God wants it to happen, it will happen. And that's where we leave it.
I don't know. That's something that I can't even answer. It's just if it happens,
oh,
it happens. Is this something I want? Sure.
Nine?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then
I'd love to see it get back together.
Yeah. You know, I don't ever want to put any pressure on you, Mike, Oz, or Tim. That's not what it's about. But it's about doing what we're called to do. And if the guys could just, and I know Timmy wants to do it because he's recently told me. I know Mike and Oz are thinking about doing it. I know they are. And I know they want to do the right thing. But if they could just take one day and go, all right, we'll do it. Now, God, we've said we'll do it. Give us that sign. Man, I'm sure something would happen.
It's real easy to lose focus, you know, and to get excited about, you know, the pictures and the clothes and the guitars and the good old days and all that was accomplished. You know, I try to be a very honest, upfront guy, and I don't want to lead any of you astray or make you believe that there's going to be a reunion by us sitting here. We've all gone our separate ways. We're doing our own thing, and I think God can and will do great things in all of our lives individually, just as He did with Stryper. But it is an honor to be here. Thank you guys. It's great to see all of you guys here, all your faces here, to be a part of this and to honor what Stryper was about. Thank you for coming. Thanks, you.
People are confused. Here I'm telling people I want the band together, and Mike's telling people he doesn't really want the band back together. So people are going, well, is it together or isn't it together? Should I go or should I not go? You know, I don't want to act like the past was no big deal. And with Stryper, I know what the future is. I know it just like I knew it back in 83. If you can influence people to look to Jesus and you don't do it, it's criminal. If the fruit's on the tree, do you chop it down? If it's alive, do you kill it? I mean, Stryper's a Lazarus waiting to come back up. You know, I'm ready for it to happen.
They read some scripture. They did prayed, read some scripture, and now they're just talking about witnessing. How to witness to people.
Just getting filled with the Spirit.
They're totally filled with the Spirit. It's awesome. Hand together. So.
Hands ready. Let's roll.
Yes.
Okay.
We're still doing the second announcement.
Yes.
So this is the one that finished us.
Stand by.
Yeah, I know they had, so did Dave Ellison. They live in Arizona where I live.
Here we go.
Really?
Hang on, there's one right behind me. Okay.
Hi, Les.
See you in a little bit, right?
Bye.
All right.
Thanks, bro. That's a fan of Phoenix loves Finn. No, I wish they'd get back together with him. Does he live in Vegas, too?
No.
Thanks, Robert. Man, God bless you, bro.
Since I've seen you.
Sweet. Hey, awesome, bro. Music, it's in the heart. It's a heart issue. That's the main thing, man. Praise God, man.